Imagine you and your family just celebrated your 65th birthday in the Bahamas. Congratulations! You're well on your way to your golden years. But while you're spending the time cruising in your brand new yacht, you see your son waste away that expensive champagne that the poor you could never afford to do so. Suddenly, you get that thought in the back of your mind. Would this wealth last even when I'm gone? Good question, because there's a good chance that you, your kids, your grandkids, or even all the way up to your great-great-grandkids, any one of you could lose all of that wealth, if you even get to that point. Statistically, you have a 1% chance of being financially stable by the time your hair turns white. And there's a 70% chance your family's financial situation can go out of control when the second generation rolls around. And it goes even higher by the third generation by a whopping 90%. That's why in today's topic at Wealthbox Academy, we'll be talking about how to create generational wealth in 6 different ways. We'll be guiding you towards the proper steps in planning your wealth to last. We also hope that by the end of this video, you're going to learn how to take care of your wealth and make sure it's best kept in the family. Also, if you're interested in similar content, please like the video and subscribe by clicking the notification bell so you can be updated whenever we post a new video. Moving on to the video, we start at number 1. Secure your cash flow. The first step in creating your wealth would be locking down on a cash flow. Well, what exactly is the term cash flow? A cash flow can be defined as the money earned by your assets after deductions. Securing a cash flow is the cornerstone of creating generational wealth. It's the gold standard, and every business-minded person needs to prioritize this as their first concern. Any asset, for example, a property you lease, can be considered a cash flow. If you've played the tabletop game Monopoly before, chances are you're pretty familiar with this strategy. In the game, your primary goal is to make as much money as possible with your assets. You buy, you hold some more. And if you were able to sustain your property to the point that there's a significant demand for it, you make a considerable difference in profit. It's kind of like that, but on a smaller scale. Buying 2 rental properties like an apartment complex or a commercial property won't really make a significant lifestyle change. Still, it will mean that you'll never even think about going hungry ever again. A rental property is the most stable way to do that. The demand for houses and commercial areas will always be there, since people will always need a place to start a family or set up a business, and it will continue to rise as time goes on. Teaching your kids this step and helping them get their own properties can ensure a reliable passive income that spans decades, which is why it's the first step you must undertake. Number 2. Utilize debt. We can regard that one of the most essential ingredients in building your wealth would be to follow the buy, borrow, die strategy. Wait, buy, borrow, die? Should I be concerned? Don't worry. Buy, borrow, die is a legal strategy created to avoid paying taxes on appreciating assets, which can then be passed on to your children or other heirs to build generational wealth. What does that mean? In simple terms, what you buy and do with it will determine what happens to it when you pass away. This strategy is a piece of foolproof advice for you to build up your wealth, and there's a slight chance you might mess it up. So, we'll visualize it for you. First, you buy things that are known as an asset. Assets are things that store value and prevent it from getting depreciated as time goes on. That means you're protecting yourself from inflation, since cash alone can fluctuate from time to time. And then, well, this might be the most crucial part. If you ever need extra money to fund your ventures, you should never use your own money. You can't sell your assets either. However, you can take out a loan if the situation allows you to. Let's imagine you just inherited a piece of land from your parents. You really don't need the money, but you can earn a nice chunk of profit if you sell the land the way it is now. So, what do? Absolutely nothing. Letting that land appreciate in value and loaning against what you need is the advisable course of action you can take. But why? The answer is taxes. Since loans are not considered income, they can't be taxed. You can buy more assets if you play it smart and use that money into a revenue stream. In turn, you can build up your portfolio, pay off your loan, then build up a good credit score. That way, the banks trust you more and you can loan more money than your previous one. Rinse and repeat. Again, you should never use your own money to fund your business growth. That's the golden rule when it comes to the world of finance. That's pretty neat, right? This is the life hack banks and rich people exploit so that they can keep on building their wealth. So as long as you refrain from spending your loans to fund a lavish lifestyle, nothing can stop your inevitable success. Lastly, when you die, at some point, you'll leave your wealth to your family members through a will or a trust fund, which we'll get to later. Sounds good, right? Well, there's just one tiny problem. Inheritance taxes. Depending on which state you live in and how wealthy you are, inheritance tax cuts in on your wealth by a whopping 17 to 40%. To create wealth that could last generations, you must always be careful with tax regulations and follow them by the book. Number 3. Buy assets. There are assets you can own other than land and rental properties. If you are a bit of an old school, you can buy and hold precious jewels and metal like gold. Historically, it's the way to go when storing wealth. People pass down gold and jewelry as an heirloom that they can sell in an event of emergency. It's also a powerful status symbol since it's portable and widely recognizable. However, holding gold may be detrimental to your generational wealth in the long run. As time goes on, technology crawls on us to even greater heights, and there's only a matter of time before we approach our spacefaring era. If that happens, gold and other precious minerals you have could be endangered, since asteroids in space have generous deposits only waiting to be claimed. Its value would just basically disappear by then. If you're from the newer generation and you're particularly tech-savvy, you can try your luck on technology-infused assets like Bitcoin. To provide a bit of context, technology can herald a change that may be for the better or for the worse. Historically, those nerds who believed in it and those who were willing to bet on its potential are now the richest individuals today. Bitcoin is one of those things. Yes, Bitcoin has been around for quite some time, but most of us don't really know the way it works. However, spending your life savings on Bitcoin is not an advisable thing to do, since too much is always bad for you. We recommend investing in at least just one Bitcoin so you can test the waters before taking it seriously. The ideal situation you can get would be that single Bitcoin can appreciate in value and make you or your kid a millionaire in the next few years. The worst case scenario, on the other hand, is that you lose a bit of money today, but you know for sure it's not your cup of tea, so you don't have to invest in it anymore. The way we see it, with the current situation happening around the globe, inflation is on the rise, and countries around the world should experience a recession in the next few years. Bitcoin has a limited supply of 21 million, and it's digitally accessible. By the time that recession comes, the world's demand for Bitcoin will inevitably rise, and everyone will want to take a slice of it. If you are interested in going in-depth on what are the best assets you can buy, you can go ahead and check out our previous video. Moving on to our fourth step, develop an evergreen business. Almost every one of us had that dream to start our own business and to see that business grow, let it prosper using our own hands. But most of us didn't really push through that idea, mainly because it's hard to start one, and it's even harder to maintain one. An evergreen business, by definition, is a multi-generational business that continues and will continue to generate money for your family, for your children even after you pass away. Don't be intimidated. Successful evergreen businesses came from humble beginnings and were often family businesses. Examples are Enzo Ferrari, founder of the Ferrari Company, and Henry Ford, the founder of the Ford Motor Company. They were one of the few instances that made it big in their field of business. But in short, every brand, every logo, and big name company out there was someone's business model that survived to this day. It pulled through because it was handed down from family to family until it became the brand name, and the family name then transitioned into the business. Tip number 5. Teach your kids. Let's be honest. Those of you who have kids dream of a better life for them, and that's why you're working very hard, so they'll never have to go through the hardships you encountered, and let them have a better shot at life. You want at least one of them to take over the family business for you, and even hope that they surpass your achievements. We may have bad news for you. Only 3 out of 10 family businesses survive to the second generation, because the kids who do inherit that wealth and fail to sustain it didn't have the necessary tools and knowledge to run it. Now, it may be due to bad parenting or personality conflict, but you can't deny that neglecting your child can be a factor in your generational wealth plan to fail. It's true that most self-made millionaires are typically people who want to change their fate so much that they often choose to work rather than spend time with their families. That's why it is important to mentor your kids by equipping them with the right tools for the job, and inspiring them to do the same by showing them how far you have reached in life. In doing that and showing them what they can also achieve in their life, they might pass on your wisdom to your grandchildren, creating a cycle of success within your family. If you want to see them grow and take care of themselves even after you're gone, you should spend time teaching your kids while also cherishing the moments you have with them. Last on our list is number 6, trust funds. A trust fund is a legal entity dedicated to holding assets for a property or organization. Aside from significantly lower tax rates, trust funds are protected from legal claims, and they're there so that the wealth you put in there will be given to its rightful owner if they pass the certain requirements you impose on them. There are a tons of ways you can do that, and you can even customize the conditions however you like. For example, you can schedule your trust fund to be released when your children get their college degree, or if they're responsible enough to handle that amount of money. Also, by the time your trust funds kick in, your children could be in their teens or in their early college years. Now, we all know that these are not the ideal time to be handling money, since in our youth, it may be more tempting than normal to give in to impulses. It's best to create trusts that will help them at the right time of their life, since that money can be the jumpstart to their own success. Before we conclude our video on how to create generational wealth in 6 different ways, we think it's time to address the elephant in the room. True, there are multiple ways in acquiring wealth, and inheriting it is probably the easiest to do. Which begs the question, would you rather want your children or grandchildren to inherit all your wealth? Or would you leave it in their hands to make their own path in life? It may be a simple choice to some, but others might struggle to answer that one. So let us know your thoughts in the comments below. As always, if you've got some value from our content, please subscribe to our channel, Wealthbox Academy, and turn on the bell button so you don't miss the next one. Thanks for watching and see you next time!